My name's Don. Thanks for joining me for a one-week trip to Myanmar, formerly called Burma, in January 1976. After spending only one day in what is called Yangon, I called it Rangoon, I took the steam train north to Mandalay to look at the temples. Yangon is an intensely crowded and busy city, and I was glad to get out. The trip by steam train took about a day, and I arrived covered in soot from the black coal burned by the engine. I met these three university students who stuck with me, showing me around for the next 4 days. They were very friendly. We climbed the highest point, the site of a large Buddhist temple, and admired the scenery. There are lots of ruins to be seen. That is the Irrawaddy River in the background, which runs the Paigan and down to Yangon. Take a cruise down the Irrawaddy River on a ferry. Buddhist monks are found everywhere and start at a very young age. I am now in the Mandalay markets looking at vendors. This lady is selling eggs. I found the women very attractive. Thanks for joining me on my one-way trip to Burma and Myanmar. Thanks, viewer, for joining me on this steam train trip from Yangon to Mandalay. I did the trip in January 1976. I was lucky enough to have a steam engine at that time. In those days, Myanmar was known as Burma, and I arrived at the capital city Rangoon, now called Yangon, and caught the train north. I took the daytime trip, and it took the entire day. Maybe 10 hours, and I was totally covered black with soot from the black smoke from the steam train. There's no glass in the windows. Here's a map of Yangon or Rangoon as I knew it. Gives you an idea of the size of the city. There's actually a railway trip that runs around the city. And here's a map of Mandalay on the Irrawaddy River. I left Mandalay and took a little cruise down the Irrawaddy, but caught the train back to Yangon. The country has almost 4,000 miles of track. It's got nearly 800 railway stations and nearly 10,000 bridges. The interesting thing is that diesel locomotives have increased from 150 to 196 between 1988 and 2003. But the steam trains have been reduced from 79 to 39. Passenger service continues to grow from 36 million to 61 million between 1988 and 2003. There's loads of websites giving information about rail services in Burma. Between Yangon and Mandalay, there's good tourist express trains. They're not steam, they're modern diesel, and they're air-conditioned. However, you do pay tourist dollars. If you get off the main lines or take the local trips, however, it's quite different, as this description outlines. This write-up indicates the fast punctual express trains that are perhaps a bit bumpy. And here's the railway timetable. The distance is 622 kilometers. The services are daily. The privately run express trains are very comfortable air conditioned with new reclining seats. Ordinary trains and coaches look as if they're made for animal transport. Delays seem to be the norm. Don't forget earplugs if you want to sleep during the night, since very loud Burmese music might be played all night. This tourist commented on the vibration and the shaking of the train. There are also pictures of the water vendors who come along, and also fruit vendors who enter the train at every stop to sell their wares. Review of the train trip indicates that it's comfortable, fairly fast, and reasonably punctual. The train leaves Rangoon at about 15 miles an hour, and young children hang on to the outside as it gradually speeds up. Once clear, the city gets up to a maximum speed of about 45 miles per hour, kicking past many small villages. You do see things like ox carts, stupas, and local Burmese children who wave wildly. Let's get on with the photographs. Here's the main railway station in Yangon in the foreground. It's a fairly mammoth building from the front, but really not many train tracks. It hardly looks like most metropolitan railroads that I know of. It's all fairly basic. These Burmese women are on their way to catch a train. Most of the trains now are electric. You probably need to negotiate to find a steam train, although I do notice that special steam trains are run on charter trips.